If you haven't explored our contact link feature for collecting information from people, you are going to love this tip. You can use a contact link in any message, but in today's example, I'm going to show you how I use it in a keyword. So imagine that I am sharing on social media that I have a special take back your time budgeting freebie that I can send to people. And if they want to get access to it, they can text time to me at 254-545-9626. When they do that, I have a reply message set up here that says, "Hi there, thanks so much for your interest. Click the link below to let me know who I'm chatting with, and your freebie will be on its way." The special part of this message is this contact link dynamic field. So in my reply message, all I did was, I'll take it out to show you from scratch. All I did was select this dynamic insert button, dynamic field, and contact link. I'm going to go ahead and confirm that. I'm going to change my spacing up a little bit here because that got a little bit funky. And I'm going to save, make sure everything looks good here. So what happens now is somebody texts me time, they get this reply message, and they have a special contact link. So I'm going to show you what happens when somebody texts in time. Let me come over here to my chat. Here we are. So I just sent time in from my Google Voice number. And you can see here, there's a phone number, they sent in time, and they got the auto reply back, right? And Project Broadcast turned that contact link dynamic field into this unique link just for this phone number. So when they click on that link, and they answer a few questions like first name, last name, and birthday, let's make today my birthday just for funsies. When they submit that form, it just lets them know their contact info has been updated. But on your end, you are going to see from Project Broadcast, hey, this person just updated their contact information. And now when you come over here to this contact, they now have a first name and last name automatically. And if you go into edit contact, you can see that their birthday is listed as well. So the contact link is just a super easy way to collect information from new contacts that you don't have a first name, last name, and birthday for. I hope this tip helps. Thanks for learning with me.